Well, the research that Ernest McCulloch and I did together began in an unusual way. We hit it off immediately and began to do experiments in an area that wasn't getting much attention at the time.
Till and McCulloch created a landscape for scientific investigation where none had existed prior to their arrival.
I don't think I knew that they were making history in the way that we understand now.
One of the things we have to understand is that since the Second World War, there has been just a fantastic revolution going on in biology and biomedical research.
I should emphasize that there was a long interval between our initial work and the kind of excitement that's filling this scientific field now. There was about a period of at least 30 years. The rapid advances have happened quite recently and have been astonishing. I mean, absolutely astonishing.
So my laboratory discovered that the adult brain has a reservoir of stem cells in it. If we understand them well and apply them properly, we'll be a big part of the future of being able to reverse and treat otherwise incurable neurological injury or disease.
My colleague Andras Naj and myself in the early 90s did an experiment which turned out to be really quite important because we demonstrated that you could generate an entire mouse from embryonic stem cells.
Since we had already developed this system of putting human cells in a mouse, we thought, well, maybe we can transplant human leukemia cells into mice. We just thought that we were building on top of what was already well known.
We discovered one of the few stem cells you can actually see in a live human body, and these are the stem cells in the retina of the eye. And in those black cells, about 1 in 500 turn out to be retinal stem cells. In the long run, this will be, I think, a cure for blindness.
Wouldn't it be amazing if we could find some place we could get stem cells from, where we could actually harvest them from the patient themselves, like a spinal cord injury victim, grow them up, turn them into what we were interested in, and then treat the patient with their own cells. And that's the reason we look to the skin.
Scientists don't really believe in miracles, but every now and then there's a discovery made that is so transformative, it may as well be a miracle.
I guess it was 2004, I think, in Nature Medicine. That was probably our first paper to show that we could actually therapeutically target leukemia stem cells and to use this kind of transplant model to develop new therapies.
Eventually, we developed a method for quantifying and detecting breast stem cells. And that just hit the field in a very big way.
Look at the breadth and the quality of the research that goes on in Canada, it's comparable to any other serious group in the world. I mean, it's just a really stellar collection of great individuals who have been pioneers in the field.
Good scientists are always training the next generation of scientists who are always training the next generation of scientists. And because of Jim and Bun, Canada punches way above its weight in stem cell research.
Stem cell biology is going to change the world. It's going to change the way we think about healthcare and the way we deliver it.
I can't say how good it makes me feel inside that I'm part of this, that I'm able to use these new tools to be able to see people get better.
I think what we will see is very steady advance toward the kinds of treatments that everybody is dreaming about.